I want to show you why you might want to push Google out of the way the next time you do a search and try Perplexity AI. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to use Perplexity step by step. Perplexity is a search engine, a very unique search engine that is powered by AI. So I'm going to do a quick comparison between Google and Perplexity just to get started here today. So on the left, I have Google. And if I go ahead and ask it a question, where will AI be in 30 years? And I'm going to ask Perplexity the same one. We're going to get our normal response where it connects to an article and tries to connect to that question that I ask. And then I'd have to go through all the different links, and a lot of them are going to be sponsored links. So then we have to be wondering about the credibility of these links that we're going to use. Now, where Perplexity shines, if I go over to this and ask the same question, and in this right now, I'm just using the free version of Perplexity, and I am later in this video going to show my pro version so you can compare what you like. But if I go ahead and just go and ask this question, what Perplexity does is it will give me the sources where it's taking this information from, and it's going to give me a summation of this. And the way it writes it, it's in a very easy to consume manner. So you can go through and read the information, but you're not done there yet. You can go through search images, search videos, generate an image. This is for the pro version. But down below, we have related. You want to dig a little bit deeper? They suggest some questions right here, or I could ask more questions. So if I look at what are some of the potential benefits of AI, now it's going to continue. And again, all the different links that it's going to put in, all the sources that it pulled it from, are going to be in the write-up. So wherever you see the number, if I click on it, it's going to bring me to that certain article so I can fact check it more. So let's dive into how to get Perplexity and how to use it with all its benefits. I'm going to be using Perplexity on Google Chrome here today, and to get to it, just go to perplexity.ai. I'll put the link down below in the description as well. If I go and look at the bottom where it says download, you can see there's the iOS app, Android app. You could click here and make it your default search, and there's also an extension that you can add as well. Now, you can go ahead without creating an account, you can go ahead and ask it a question. So if I go, and I'm just going to choose one of these ones right here, so how to tune in a piano, it will go through and search for that information. You can see the links are up here and where the different sources are, based on just like I showed you before when I was comparing it to Google. But the one thing is, if you don't have an account, your different searches won't be saved, and you can't take advantages of the few other things like uploading a PDF to examine. If I go over to the library here, I can't get to my saved ones. And that's an important thing, so I can go back and look at the different conversations I've had. So in this case, I'm going to just go and create an account with my Google. And you can see that you can do it with a custom email as well. But I'm just going to be using this demo account here to create my Perplexity account. And you can see how quick you can do this. So I'm just going to keep everything the same. I could go ahead and change my username if I want, but I'm just going to go and hit continue. This is the Try Pro if you were going to go upgrade right away, but I'll come back to that at the end to show you just, again, some of the benefits of using Pro, and we'll compare them with some of the searches. Now that I'm logged in, if I go and ask a question, and we'll go with how intelligent are dolphins, take a look at it over here. I do have options for the pro search. You get so many in a day. I believe you get like 4 with the free version. And then when you have the pro version, you get a lot more. So if I go ahead and ask a question about dolphins, it will go through and provide me. I can see this is a pro search right here. And if I expand this, it shows me the searching the web, found 20 sources. And look over on the right, we have our different images. I can search videos here that will connect to. Now, the other thing I want to point out, now that I'm logged in, I also have this in my library. So these will grow, and you can go back to them and continue that conversation if you get an idea of what you might want to be asking, and you can continue on. You can also go and click the X here to remove any of them. We also have a Discover tab, and this is kind of like a news feed here that will go through, and you can click on any of these. And as soon as you do, you can apply Perplexity to this to ask questions, and then kind of go down the rabbit hole of that information that you're searching for. Now, if I go back to home here, let's try a few searches, and then I'm going to show you about uploading a file, how you can take a PDF file and have it sum it up for you and find specific things in it. What I really like about Perplexity is that I can use current information with AI. Now, if you're familiar with maybe using ChatGPT for doing searches, if you don't have the paid for account, you are only up to a certain date. But in this case, what are the latest advances in AI in March 2024? So if I go ahead and search this, you'll see right here that the dates they're pulling this information from is in March 2024. And if I go through and look at the related, they can see I'm probably looking for a current here. So I can go and do one of these suggestions ones, and it's going to keep looking at the date. So I really like that option for that type of search. If I go back to home here, I'm going to ask it another question now. Use Perplexity to create a recipe for you. In this case, I need something very specific, 40 grams of protein, 5 grams of fiber, and chicken, vegetables, and I like it spicy. If I send this off here in Perplexity, it will find the recipe that I could use that meets this criteria. It's the spicy chicken and vegetable stir fry. Notice as I go through, it has the instructions of it. I can ask more questions. It didn't have the sources in there, so I can say, what are the sources of this? And it will break it down with the different links in this. At the bottom of any of the answers that Perplexity gives you, take a look at the options that you have. You have share link. So if you click on this, it copies the link. I'm going to go and click up on share up here. It turned it to shareable. Usually it starts off with secret if you didn't want anybody to see it. But as soon as it becomes shareable, you could go quickly to social media like Twitter and do a tweet about that. Or you could send it in an email. You can also turn it back to secret if you didn't want to share it out. You can also do a rewrite based on the different options that you have here. So from Pro Search to GPT-4 Turbo to Claude, and you can see all the different options. If you wanted to copy the text out of here, just go copy, and then you can paste it into what you need it to. And then we can edit our query if you needed to make a change to the specific question that you're asking. Let's say I just got a new coffee maker and I want to learn all about it so I can make the best cup of coffee. I learn best from watching videos on this type of thing, and I want to make sure that I get all the information so it needs to be in depth. So there's the question right there I asked. I can also do a search specifically, filter it through YouTube. So normally it's just on all as a focus, but if you go and change it to YouTube, or you can see the other options you get, now it's going to go and specifically look on YouTube for those. It shows me the different sources of the videos. There's two more here. Gives me a little information on each of these about what video, and maybe gives me a good idea of what video I'd want to start with, because then I can just click on these right here and it's going to bring me to that specific video. I want to focus in on this attach feature. Notice that we can attach images, text, PDFs. And with the free version, you can do 3 a day. I'm going to do the PDF. If I go ahead and click on this, I could go grab a PDF on my desktop. Let's say you come across it on the internet. Here's an article or a PDF. This is about 50 something pages and I want some help summing it up. If you just click download and then when it pops in, what you can do is just drag it down as well. So if I take this PDF that I downloaded and just bring it over. So it goes ahead and uploads this and I can go ahead and summarize this file, what is the conclusion, or ask my own question. So maybe I want to know what industries will be affected by AI. So if I go ahead and ask this question, it's going to be based upon this information that I just uploaded here. And I have looked at this article and I know these are the different ones that they do mention in here, but they've summed it up. And then I can continue on with asking my own questions or the different ones that they suggest here. So when I see this, how will AI impact the job market in the future? I'm going to go ahead and choose this. It's still connected to this file right here on the upload. So you can go and dig down inside of this to find all this information just by asking questions to it for free inside Perplexity. Take advantage of Perplexity for academic research. Make sure you have your focus area here to academic, or you could actually prompt it in to tell it to search for academic. But if I was asking it a question like this, how can higher education institutions integrate AI into their curricula? I'm not gonna read the whole thing, but I'm gonna go and just hit enter. When it comes back with the information, all the sources are gonna be of those of the academic variety. And as it goes through, it sums this up for me. So it gives me ideas of different articles I could read. These are gonna be connected through the links. And then I can even dig down, like always, with more questions to get an understanding and to find out more all the time. Now, I've just moved over to my pro version, and what it does for you, if I was going to ask some of the questions that I asked the free version before, and I'll just send this over. One thing the pro version does, it can help you kind of get your search more accurate, because now it's asked me, do we want this under 30 minutes, 30, 60 minutes, over 60 minutes, or is there something specific that maybe I wasn't thinking of before? So I can just click one of these, and now when I send it, it's going to add that other component, that criteria into it, fetching the recipe for me. And inside the pro version, if I go to generate image, I can do this right within Perplexity. So let's do a photograph. And it went and created this image using AI of the specific spicy chicken and vegetable stir fry recipe. And I'm looking at that thinking, yeah, that's probably a pretty accurate looking at the recipe and what it should look like. I'm thinking that looks quite realistic. Again, if I try the same question under academic, when I use the pro version, it's going to prompt me for some more specific details. So if I wanted this to be connected with business and send it, then that criteria changes. So with the pro version, it's always trying to help me to get to a more specific answer to pinpoint what exactly what I'm looking for. And with all the different AI models that it has working for you, it just becomes, it will help you kind of probably find something that you didn't even know that exists as you dig through with the specific questions that it gives you after. Creating content is another important feature to use inside Perplexity. Now, if I was going to go and ask it to create a blog post about AI advancement in the next five years aimed at teachers. Now, I'm in the pro version. You can do this in the free version, but I enjoy working with the pro version just as it breaks down more questions and helps me along the way. So if I send this out, I could have chose to go academic too. So if you wanted it to be based on scholarly, I could have done that, but I'm just going to keep this for all focuses. I want it to be K to 12, and I'm going to send that. And we'll see if it goes through again. Sometimes it'll even go through a second time and give me more options on how I want it to break down. Let's take a look at what it wrote. And we have navigating the future, AI advancements in the next 5 years. As I go through, I can see all the different information that's cited to the different web pages. And it wrote this article fairly quickly. Now, what's fun to do if you need an image, just go over to generate image and we'll do a photograph again. It's going to generate that image based on what I told it to write with this blog post. Here we go. This is kind of a creepy looking picture, but you get the idea that what it was trying to do. I could try to regenerate if I didn't like this as well. The last thing I want to show you today is under the library. So you can see all my different prompts that I've asked it, but you can make collections. So I'm going to go over to here and just click get started. If I click get started here, and I'll just call this demo AI, and the description is going to be about collecting info on AI, and I'm going to go and hit create. So right now this is shareable. So with this, I'm going to click on this and I can now add threads to this, and all of this can be shared amongst that one thread, and then I can collaborate with other people. So I could go start generating based on the suggestions or asking it just like I did before. And this is available in the free model as well. So what do you think? Do you think Perplexity is better than Google search? Is this something that you could see yourself using? Is this a time saver? Are you going to get exactly to what you need to? I know for myself, it's something I'm using more and more. And as I created the habit, I like the results I'm getting. I still go back to Google, but as this evolves, or maybe Google will evolve to have this all built in as well. Anyways, thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.